In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at a lot of info from Rockstar Insider FunMW2 regarding what Rockstar will be doing next, some changes they've made to the game via an update, and a whole lot more. So the first thing from FunMW2 doesn't have anything to do with something he said, but just a very, very direct hint at what's going to be coming up next. So if you take a look at his profile page on Twitter right now, you'll notice that he's changed his avatar or his picture. And that person is the main character from the Speed Racer cartoon. Now, why is that important? Well, one of the vehicles added in the After Hours update is based off of one of the cars in Speed Racer, the Mach 5. And that vehicle is the Scramjet. So I think that it is very clear that this is FunMW2 hinting to players that the Scramjet is going to be releasing next in Grand Theft Auto Online. I also think it's pretty clear because Rockstar also sort of hinted that it was going to be one of the next few vehicles released too. If you guys remember, they put out this tweet about a week ago where they outlined a lot of the vehicles that were going to be coming soon. On that list, they featured the Oppressor Mark II, the Terabyte, the B-11 Strike Force, and the Scramjet. So three out of those four have been released. The only one that's remaining is the Declasse Scramjet. So it would not shock me at all if that is the next vehicle to be added. And according to FunMW2, he's hinting at that vehicle coming out next. So because the Scramjet is going to be coming out next, let's talk about some details of this vehicle. First and foremost, it's going to be available on the Warstock Cash and Carry site. It's actually not the final vehicle on this site, but we are getting close to the end, as you guys can see right here. It has a buy it now price of $4,628,000 and a trade price of $3,400,000. So this is also important because the way you get that trade price is if you win the Hunting Pack Remix Adversary Mode. So since we know the Declasse Scramjet is going to be coming out on Tuesday, we also know that because the trade price has to be unlocked the same day, we also know we're going to be getting our first new adversary mode, Hunting Pack Remix. Now, in case you guys have never played Hunting Pack, it's an adversary mode that's pretty interesting. You have four players. You have an attacker and a defender. Basically, you have a runner who has to pick up speed and maintain it all the way to the deactivation zone. And you have attackers that have to bring it to a halt, while you have a team of defenders that try and protect it. So basically, you've got one person driving like a, you know, an interesting sort of vehicle, whether it's a money truck or a taco van or anything like that, like a fire truck. And then you've got a team of people trying to slow it down and a team of people trying to protect it. So it's going to be a remixed version of that, whatever that is. I don't know, but it does sound like it will be pretty fun. And hopefully Rockstar do a good job with it. I've always stated that the vehicle-based adversary modes are typically the best ones that Rockstar do. Sumo, Vehicle Vendetta, etc. So I expect, hopefully, that this will be the exact same thing as well. Now, the only other thing we know for sure that's going to be coming out on Tuesday is the final radio station update. It's going to feature the Black Madonna's mix for Los Santos Underground Radio. And that is it after that as far as updates to the radio and all the DJs go. So we know that those three things are going to be coming out on Tuesday. Now, there's always a possibility that Rockstar release more than one vehicle, but I would assume because this is going to be a pretty expensive one, obviously we know that, and it's going to be just a vehicle that Rockstar wants people to focus on, I think the Scramjet will be the only car released during this week. Now, moving on, and this is sort of just my speculation, but I'm really starting to believe that Rockstar is cranking out the After Hours drip feeding content. I don't think they have ever gone this quickly in terms of releasing content after an update comes out. So it's kind of led me to believe that maybe the drip feed for After Hours wasn't formulated to hold the Grand Theft Auto Online player base while RDR2 is out, but instead just hold us long enough until RDR2 releases. Because if what FunMW2 is saying is correct and the Scramjet comes out this Tuesday, we only have two new vehicles left after that, the Menacer, and then you've got the Freecrawler. The rest would just be old content with new updates, and that includes the adversary modes. So I think that this is good news for future Grand Theft Auto Online updates, because there's no way at the pace Rockstar is going at right now that they would be able to get this content to all the way in December. So I think this is good news for an update to come out after Red Dead Redemption 2 has been released. Again, I'm still kind of torn on what Rockstar is going to do. A lot of people have been saying there could be another small DLC before RDR 2 comes out. That's not happening. We're like 2 weeks from September, and then September is October. October is going to be all about RDR 2. So that's not going to happen. This is the final update before Red Dead Redemption 2. But as far as after Red Dead Redemption 2 goes, I think there's a great chance we could see another update in 2018. I'm sure that Rockstar does want to focus on Red Dead Redemption 2 and RDR Online, but I guarantee you that they're also not just going to completely abandon Grand Theft Auto Online as well. I mean, with what we've seen so far in terms of the amount of people playing, what, you know, the Take-Two Interactive CEO Strauss Zelnick has said, that, you know, Grand Theft Auto Online is doing so great. It really does believe that they've got more stuff cooking for GTA 5 and that this is not going to be the end. But as far as new content before RDR 2, I don't think that is very likely. Now, really, the only odd thing I think about the Scramjet releasing this early is I thought this was going to be the Halloween vehicle. But if you think about it, with RDR 2 sort of releasing near Halloween, maybe Rockstar said that would kind of be too complicated, so I can understand why it would be released now. And maybe this year we won't get a Halloween update. This might be the first year in which Rockstar skips that, because they really have sort of backed themselves into a corner here with RDR 2 and Halloween happening less than a week away. So I think this is bad news for a Halloween update, but it might be good news for another update in 2018. Now, in addition to that, FunnMW2 has also provided some more information on some changes that Rockstar have actually made to Grand Theft Auto Online via a background update. So a couple changes. He said the Speedo Custom no longer explodes after placing a landmine. Apparently that's an issue. Clarifying on that, he said you can't place landmines if your Speedo Custom is armored. You have to remove the armor plating in order to use them. This is because the armor is what caused the Speedo mine to explode from placing your own mines. You may not have experienced it, but others did. The next thing Rockstar changed was fixes for the Oppressor Mark II placement. I'm not sure what they meant by that, maybe in which it spawns in or how it functions when you move it from and to the Terabyte. Who knows? They also added fixes for the Terabyte. Apparently, they didn't get through all of them, because if you caught my video earlier today, you know there's a handful of things that are wrong with it that have not been fixed. They also fixed weapon selection to be unavailable while using the drone. That's obviously a good thing. You don't want people flying around being able to use, you know, RPGs and stuff like that. And then they also fixed an issue that allowed you to knock NPCs in the club. I have never been able to hit any of the NPCs in the club, so again, this must have been a pretty rare issue. Is it something that I had ultimately never experienced? So that right there is pretty cool. We have a good idea of what's going to be coming out on Tuesday. And once again, that is going to be in just a few short days, as Rockstar confirmed. This is going to be 1 week long, so that will be happening on August 21st. And we know we're going to be getting the Scramjet at a minimum, the Hunting Pack Remix Adversary Mode, and the new mix on the radio station. But other than that, it is going to be a mystery what Rockstar could include. And then, of course, they've been updating Grand Theft Auto Online with lots of little fixes and changes, some more background updates that they've been introducing into the game. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. Hopefully, you did enjoy. If you did, be sure to leave a like rating on this video. That would be awesome. And also, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new. You like daily GTA 5 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care. And I'll see you guys in the next video.